We are Greybeard. Welcome to the Promotion Studios here in Market Square in downtown Knoxville. And we're going to play our first song for you right now. We'll be right back.
she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gone to stay. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. Keep on turning.
go round and round. And those steel rails are so cold and hot, for the monsters they go down. Now love, where would you be right now without love? Baby, baby, won't you put it down? Won't you put it down? Baby, 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 won't you put it down? When the big train runs, when the train is moving on, gotta keep on moving, gotta keep it moving, gotta keep on moving, gotta keep it moving.
Promotion Studio. Today we're joined by Greybeard. What's going on?
What's up?
Glad to have you guys here with us. And give us a little background on the band, how you guys met, and why you decided to start playing music together.
Who wants to go?
I've been around the Knoxville music scene for several years. One of your other bands, Belfast Six Pack, signed with you guys. I was their original drummer. I stepped away to do some things for my family. I met this knucklehead a few years back. We've both been on stage before and wanted to get on stage. Met him. We've talked about it and talked about it and talked about it. And finally, we decided to pull the trigger. And he knew Rick, and he said, let's try to put something together. So the three of us met, and instantaneously when we met, it was good chemistry.
Oh, yeah.
Everything worked out. And then we've had some other people there filling the roles, great musicians. They just didn't fit the part for us, for Greybeard. And then we brought these other two gentlemen in, and then brought her in to do the harmonies, what's missing, what we can't hit, and it kind of works now. It fits.
Hell yeah. So when you guys are picking out songs, do you guys bring anything to, like, is anything on the table?
Anything.
Yeah.
We do everything from a couple country tunes in there that we've rocked up and heavied up, and, you know, the funk, like Superstition and The Wolf, things like that. I mean, classic rock, new rock, I mean, we cover it all.
Oh, yeah. And is everybody allowed, like, a veto on a song? Be like, no, I will not play that song?
I mean, there are certain songs that we have all agreed that, no.
No Skinnerd.
No, we won't cover any Skinnerd. We just, that was a rule. We said, no Skinnerd. I mean, it just, because it's just, you know, it's done so much.
Yeah, I'm sure you all know how to play and sing Skinner.
And we you've
probably done it before.
If I play Give Me Three Steps one more time, I will die. That will be my last day on this planet.
And that's the goal we set out. It's not that we don't want to play or won't play it. If you look around the scene, there are many great bands out there that's their niche. Some of them are Southern Rock. Some of them are this, that, or the other. They all have their particular thing that specifies them. That's what we want to be different with Greybeard. We want to pick out songs that not everybody's doing, is a little less heard, and doing the Greybeard way, our way.
Yeah, that's another thing, is you guys add a lot of little, like, kind of Southern rock flair to some of these songs. Was that something that you guys just came on organically?
Me and Brian both grew, we're both, you know, played in everything from country bands, you know, well, God, he's a shredder, but he's played just more country than I probably have. But, I mean, that's just kind of who we are. I mean, we kind
of every minute of it.
Yeah, it's kind of bred into us. I mean, you know.
That's why it clicks. That's why it works. Is we're all from kind of the same similar background, some type of Southern rock, Southern metal, some kind of background like that. And we've all done it before, and that's why we get along well with each other. It just, that gear locks in.
Yeah.
Machine moves.
Once everything starts clicking on all cylinders, that's when you know you got something you're working with. It's really unique because you don't hear a lot of people do, when they do covers, they kind of try to make them sound as close to the original. Doing your own unique style of it, that's what makes them stand out to people.
Well, when we decided to do this, and one of the things that the three of us, when we sat down at a table to make a list of some of this stuff and everything like that, we point blank said we don't want to be a jukebox band.
Right.
Because if you're one of those bands that it's got to be note for note, tone for tone, why not have a DJ?
Yeah.
What's the point of doing it? I just soon have a DJ so I can request what I want to hear.
Yeah.
But if we do it our own way, so we always sound like us when we play it, people are going to dig that. People are going to come to hear your version of something, how you do it.
Absolutely. I mean, that when it's a good song like that and you can do it in a unique way, you'd be surprised how often your version gets caught in people's heads.
It's different. People like different. I mean, right. You can't be the same old, same old. People got to have something different to remember you for.
Absolutely.
It's every time you play a show, no matter what you do, you can't please everybody. You're always going to have that one person that's not even filming. They're just on their phone, social media, trying to hook up the girl, trying to hook up the guy, whatever's going on. But when you make them, when they're on
their
phone,
up, they're like,
and they're like, I know that song, and you look up like,
yeah,
and you get that inquisitive look like, oh, cool. And you take that 15 seconds of their time, 30 seconds of their time, 2 minutes, or if they put their phone down for the rest of you're playing that song, makes it worthwhile.
Hell yeah.
That's what our goal was.
Absolutely. So how often do you guys practice, and what's practice like?
So practice is, we practice at my house. I've got a studio at home, all the way down in Teleco Plains. We all go to Teleco.
Everybody's commuting to Teleco. What's the furthest drive somebody has to Teleco?
Probably...
It's a 100 miles round trip.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it's right out. Wow.
And then Augie probably be next because he goes from Greenback to Teleco.
So. Very cool.
But we our practice we practice generally if we've got a bunch of shows coming up, then it's we try to do it twice a week. I mean that's the goal. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not. Some people, you know, we get sick, we have kids, you know, life.
Yeah, absolutely.
Life happens.
Yeah, life comes up.
And so, but we get together at least once a week, period. I mean, that's pretty much been our standard, and then we get two in. Sometimes we flip back and forth. We'll do one week, two the next. You know, we do it based on kids' visitation schedules and things of that nature to try to, you know, still try to get our family time, you know, because that is important to all of us.
Yeah. So is it very regimented? You guys come in like we're here for 2-3 hours, we're going to knock out the set twice, or is it, hey, you know what, we might barbecue some as
it's,
well.
It's more like an ADHD playlist. You know, it's basically as close to that, you know, summing it up as I can. You know, we
there's
may start out.
There's squirrels involved.
There's
squirrels.
Yeah. Squirrels.
Yeah,
squirrels.
And funny thing about it is that's how we've come up with some of the songs on our playlist, because we come in, we've got, okay, this is what we're going to focus on this week, and then one of us squirrels and starts playing the riff, then two or three people.
The young
join
man
in,
with the long
like,
brown hair.
Well, hey, that song came together in 5 minutes. Let's run through it. And then it gets, within a few practices, it's added to the set list or whatever. So, that, again, that's what's cool about this project. It's nice and smooth and just flows.
So, everybody comes to this table just sometimes and be like, man, I think this song would be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what we do is we do have a wish list.
Okay.
And we do designate it. We've got a dry erase board in the studio, and we write, okay, you know, I'd like to do this song, and we put it up there. And then it's a matter of, okay, can we do this song? Is it something that we can pull off? Can the lead singer actually sing it?
Can you put your own spin on it?
Can we put our own spin on it? Because we don't want it to sound like, you know, just the same thing. And that's part of where we have developed our own sound is... because we don't want it to sound like the same old thing. And so that adds a little difficulty,
oh, yeah.
I guess, you know, because there are certain songs that you can't.
It's, yeah,
you just can't.
You've got to, well, yeah, you, at that point you're deconstructing and writing a new song sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do you guys have any aspirations to write original music?
Oh, yeah.
Yep,
this year.
This year?
The goal is to start that this 2023 is the year that we're actually going to start putting some originals together.
Hell yeah.
And here we go.
Yeah,
hoping to have an album's worth done by the end of the year. I mean,
it's
a loose goal.
Yeah.
Hoping for the end of the year.
You guys already got some songs you're kind of working to get, some things in the cooking pots.
Good,
I know,
riffs.
We got riffs and ideas and things of that nature. We haven't really pursued it really hard because we've actually got a bunch of shows.
Yeah, you've been
up.
Busy. Yeah,
and
that's
so,
a good problem to have. Though.
That's a very good, you know, and that's just it. We are a working band, and so finding the time to be able to do that, sit down and write together. And so what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to try to play double duty.
Yeah,
work on our set list. And
one practice writing session, one set practice session.
Yeah. Yep, and that's kind of where we're going with it.
Right on. So when that music comes out, or if anybody wants to book you for shows, what's the best way for people to reach out and get in touch with you?
Well, obviously.
Facebook. Promotion?
Promotion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Promotion.
Our Graybeard Band on Facebook, a direct message to us. That has been the easiest way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
right, somebody's always watching it, and it's easy to respond to.
Yeah, when you got six members of a band, somebody's always got their phone on.
Yeah.
Somebody's always going to see that.
Yeah, one of us is going to respond to it.
Right on.
We've got phone numbers and so on listed on the Graybeard Band page. We do have
the website.
We've got our website. That is graybeardbandofficial.net. That's it.
Got to get all those tags and handles. Perfect, man.
Yes.
Yeah. So when people get that new album, 2023, you're going to maybe get it out next year or so?
2024 is probably the
hell yeah.
The more realistic goal.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, look forward to original music from Graybeard, and until then, check them out. follow them on Facebook, Graybeard Band, and then Graybeard Official, Graybeard Band Official.
GraybeardBandOfficial.net.
Yeah, so hit that up. Go out and check out our show. And until next time, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below. That way you don't miss another Promotion Live session.